Hi guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome again to another painting tutorial. Today I'll be painting something new, something that I've never done, and it will be a one subject painting, meaning we will be focusing on the object and getting to the smallest details as much as possible. I'll be painting a seashell, and I'm just so excited because again, this is my first time to do something like this. And you know what? We will be using only a few colors today, so you're not gonna be stressing so much about the colors. You know, sometimes I use unusual colors, but I think today I'll be using universally available acrylic paints. So here are the colors that I'll be using for today's tutorial. We have titanium white, burnt sienna, lemon yellow, yellow ochre, and as you can see here, my canvas paper is already painted black because the background for this painting is black. So I'm gonna sketch first the subject. By the way, I'm gonna write in the description box below the size of the canvas paper that I'm using, because this is my first time that I'm using this canvas paper that I have. I didn't know that I bought this one. It's been a while since the last time I checked my supplies. So early this morning I dug up some of my old materials and I found out this sketchbook. Anyway, long story short, I have a new canvas paper, and the only information that I got here was its size 5WD. I don't know what it means, but I'm gonna find it out later and write in the description box below. Let's get painting. So I'm gonna sketch first the subject, and for the sketch I'll be using some white. Okay, I'll be using any brush will do. This is just a sketch part, so I'm just so excited. I'm gonna be using white. Let's see how this goes. Let's see how this goes. Okay, so I'm gonna sketch first. This is just a sketch, so I don't want you to go stressing so much about what I'm doing. Just watch me first if you want, or you can actually just paint along with me, doesn't matter. I'm gonna do first the shape, because you know, once we're done with the shape, it's so much easier for me to continue with everything else. All right. Ooh. Okay. And like that. So I'm just showing you the shape. Okay, you can actually see now the seashell type of thing. So I'm gonna make this quite fatter, because I want to make use of the space as much as possible. Okay, now I'm gonna underpaint my subject. I'm gonna use burnt sienna and yellow ochre. I'm gonna add a little bit of white. I don't know why I did not get black, but I'll be using black. Maybe because my canvas is already underpainted black. That's why I forgot to tell you that I'll be using black. So I'll be using this color, maybe add a little more white and black. This is just the underpainting, so I'll be painting over again. I know that we did the sketch line, but my only purpose is for you to see the shape. I'll be painting over the sketch line because it's not part of the game. I'm not really concerned about the direction of my brush strokes because we're just underpainting. Later, the sketch lines will be completely gone. Okay, I'll be getting my white. And I'm not washing my brush, I'm just lightening some areas already. Alright, and then I'm gonna get some gray, so I'll be getting my white. As you can see here, I'm not really washing my brush. I'm getting my gray, okay, maybe this color. And I'm just gonna use this color to color like this part of the shell. Okay, I'm gonna get my white and brown and yellow. Okay, I'm just gonna color. Maybe this is too yellow, but I'm just gonna make some adjustments later. For now, I'm gonna do this. And of course, I'm using my fingers because I want to blend with my fingers. I think it's more effective. I'm gonna dab onto my brown and black. Just gonna, oops, that's pure black, sorry. I'm just gonna underpaint this corner or this side. gonna get my white. I'm changing brush simply because my brush is just, the brush that I was earlier using was quite thick. So I was having a hard time getting into the smallest indentations of the subject. Just like that. I'm gonna brighten this part. Okay, I'm gonna get my black and I'm gonna darken this area so that I give it more depth. So it's all about blending. Alright, I'm gonna get my black and I'm just gonna outline. My brush is kind of thick. Anyway, I'm just gonna make some adjustments later. Alright. Some black right here. All right, just like that. I think I'll be using a more pointy brush because my brush is quite big. So I'll be getting my black still. And let's create some more detail. Like that. Okay, and maybe here. Okay, just like that. Okay, now I'm getting some yellow ochre. So I'm gonna get my yellow ochre plus burnt sienna. And I'm gonna apply that right here. So you can see here there's no particular pattern because we want to create some natural looking patterns on the shell. Also, right here, I'm gonna get my yellow. We're going to lighten some areas. Okay, I'm gonna get my burnt sienna. I'm gonna create some patterns on the shell. All right, this is quite weird because the white just mixed with the brown. I'm gonna add yellow ochre and black and white and yellow. Okay, I'm gonna try to create some little patterns. On the shell, so it's like this. Just be gentle with the way you apply it. Okay, be gentle, don't press so hard on the canvas. Now I'm starting to delete the sketch line. Now I'm getting some black. And I'm mixing a little bit of brown to the black, so it's not super black. Are we filming? Yes, we are. Adding water so that it glides smoothly on the canvas. So make some lines that are like this. Okay, now I'm gonna get my yellow plus brown. So just go quite randomly. I'm getting my white. Just get your white. And it's okay if there are some yellows going on. I'm gonna apply some white. And I'm using my fingers to push out the paints. All right, I'm gonna color it with some yellow ochre. But then again, I'm using my fingers to spread the paint. You know, the reason why I'm doing that is it's really effective for me when I do that. Okay, some yellowy colors. I'm getting some gray and I want to create some gray color. So I'm applying some streaks of white. This is just yellow ochre. I'm creating some lines following the curvatures of the seashell. So I'm gonna get my black so that we create some dimension. And then some yellows. I'm adding some browns. Okay, let's move here. Before we go back to that area, let's just make some more detailing right here. This is just gray. But since we're not washing our brush, there is some presence of other colors, which is good. All right, just like that. I'm gonna change my brush. I'm just gonna use a cleaner brush. I'm gonna dab onto my white, and using white, I'm gonna brighten some areas. Just like that. I'm gonna get my black again. So we're going to create some natural looking patterns on the shell. gonna get my white. I'm gonna get my brown and black. I try my best not to always wash my brush because the presence of other colors on my paintbrush helps in making some natural patterns that I probably won't achieve if I keep on washing my brush. Gonna darken okay, and I'm gonna make some more darker browns. Gonna dab on some browns and some yellows. I'm gonna apply some light browns right here. Everything is just marking here. I'm just marking. And I'm also allowing the brush to do some work that I probably wouldn't get if I keep on, you know, controlling my brush. Let the brush do some of the job for me. Let me check. Okay, wow. I'll be adding more details because although I'm happy about it, I'm not yet fully happy about it. So I'm gonna get a more pointy brush. All right, I'll just use this pointy brush. I'm gonna get my white. Okay, but I'll be adding some brown to my white so that it's not super white. So it's like this. It's like almost skin color. And I'm just gonna outline the shape. So I'm gonna gray some areas. It gives it more dimension. Okay, I'm gonna gray this part because again, we wanna give it dimension. So I'm adding some watered down black to this area. Okay, using some yellow, I'm just gonna yellow some areas. I'm using it watered down, you know, just to not paint over the area, but more of glaze it. To give it more light effect. And also right here. Again, we do not want to be, we do not want the areas to be super painted over. We just want to glaze it. And besides, my yellow is quite transparent, so it's not really an issue. It's too much. I think I made a mistake here. It's too much black. Again, we want to outline this part. Okay, very subtle application of an outline. You don't want to do too much like in your face outline. But we want to make sure that it's outlined. I'm gonna darken this part to give it more dimension. You know what? A lot of this involved techniques more than just coloring it. I'm applying some white. All right, and for this point, I'm gonna make it more gray. So just gray it down to make it like disappearing in the background because of perspective. Again, get some black but water it down, and I'm just gonna darken this side. Just darken the sides because we want to make sure that it's curvy. So to emphasize the curve, we need to do some contrasting of colors. Oops, it's too dark. Also here. Okay. I'm gonna get my fan brush because I want to create some lines that are quite irregular looking. So I'm gonna get my yellow and white, just combine, and then brown, just combine. And as you can see, I'm not really mixing them. I just want them, the three colors, to be there. And I'm gonna carefully make some line. Gonna get some brown and black. Let's try this one. All right, just like that. Okay, and I'm gonna get more white. Then some more highlights. Let me check, because I really haven't checked. Okay, this is good. Oh my God. Okay, I'm gonna, right, it's dry. I'm gonna make it a little more dark to give it more dimension. So I'm using just watered down black. Also here, to give it more curve. Just like that. And then I'm gonna get my yellow ochre because I really want to lighten the center part. So using my watered down yellow ochre, I'm just gonna paint over the center portion of the shell to give it more light and dimension. Okay, now I'm getting my yellow with white and to apply that again on the center, but this time mid-center, like the centermost part. I'm gonna add a little bit of yellow on this part of the shell just to make everything connected. Just like that. Okay, I'm getting my white. And again, glaze it. And using white, I'm gonna make some markings, especially on the middle section. The farthest point should be appearing more white because perspective wise it looks farther. Let me check. This is, gosh, this is nice. Let me check. Wow, this is nice. So you can actually clean the area by just painting over those sketch lines that were outside the main subject's outline. I'm just cleaning it because I want it nice and solid. right. Let me check. Oh my gosh, I love this one. Okay, I think I'm gonna sign this now. We're done. So I'm gonna sign this now because, wow, I like this one. Okay, so we're done, and I hope you enjoyed this one. And if you like this video, this, you know, not very usual type of video from me, go ahead and like this video and let me know in the comment section below what you think about this painting. See you in my next video. Bye guys. Love you.